Things I've learned as a first-time mom, part 6. I don't know about you, but I have one of those babies that want to be cuddled 24/7. So I found a way to trick her into thinking I'm still holding her. A rolled-up blanket between her hands and her legs. This works great for the afternoon naps, gives me a chance to do my own thing. Who knew?
Spent the night in one of those sleep pods in the airport, and here's what it was like. I had an 11-hour overnight layover in Munich on my way back from Greece, so I decided to make it an adventure and try one of these pods. I had no idea what to expect, but when I saw them for the first time, I was pretty excited because this was pretty nice. I booked it in advance the day of just to make sure it was available, but it was so easy to check in, you just put in your booking code. And although it's small, it felt pretty spacious inside and was also super clean. At the end of the bed, there's a control screen that says how much time you have left, and you can also play some music or change the lights. I loved the orange lights. And the bed even had a really comfy blanket, so it was honestly pretty cozy. This is the view from the bed, and it honestly felt super secure. I pulled down the privacy curtain so no one could see in, and the pod also locks. Although it's not soundproof, I could definitely hear the cleaning crew outside. I got a full 6 hours of sleep. So after a quick lymphatic drainage massage, because I always wake up so puffy, I was able to start the final leg of my journey home completely well rested, which was a total game changer for jet lag. You book by the hour, and it was around 80 euros for 7 hours, so it's cheaper than a hotel, and I also got to wake up right next to my gate. So if you book the cheaper flights and have a long layover somewhere, definitely give these a try.
Cleaning my sister's rat's nest that she likes to call a bedroom. Today while she was at work, I called to see when she was going to be home. Then she started telling me about how stressed she was that she had to come home and clean up this disaster of a room. So since I didn't have many plans today, I decided to dedicate a few hours of my time to knock this room out. I know I'm already going to get so many horrible comments talking about how disgusting this room is and she's such a nasty person for letting it get like this. But the thing is, if you are able to keep your room clean, that is amazing. I'm so happy for you. However, you do have to understand that some people do struggle with keeping their area clean, especially when there's a stressful event going on in their life. So instead of judging someone and asking why it's so gross, offer a helping hand because you never know what someone's going through. Since this wasn't my mess, I didn't know exactly what to do with everything. I kind of just did my best and turned it into organized chaos. Since I no longer live with my parents, her room is typically the room that I stay in when I come into town. So to keep things more organized for her and me, I bought a few organizing racks to try to keep things more organized underneath the sink, as well as a new organizer for the shower. After I was done with that, that pretty much wrapped up everything. And now my sister gets to come home from work to a nice clean room. So baby, do it right, do me right. We can go over fast. We can move faster than wine. When you put your body on mine and collide, collide. We could be one of those nights, but we don't turn off the light. Wanna see your body on mine and collide, collide. Baby, it's all yours if you want me. All yours if you want me. Put it down if you want me tonight. It's all yours if you want me. All yours if you want me. Put it down if you want me. Collide.
This is 100% your look, Connie baby.